Velkommen I den store amfikonsertsalen I studentbygget Chateau Neuf I Oslo. De som I øyeblikket I ferd med å innta podiet The Killer Force, som de kaller seg. Det 15 unge, og for oss hittil ukjente amerikanske musikere. Når stemningen allikevel forventningsfull og til å ta og føle på, så skyldes det selvsagt kapellmesteren selv, trommefantomet Buddy Rich. Allerede som treåring begynte Buddy Rich sin karriere som steppdanser og rytmisk vidunderbarn. 11 år gammel ledet han sitt første orkester, og siden har han holdt seg I sentrum for verdens oppmerksomhet, og nå har han faktisk rukket å bli snart 60 år. Her kommer han, elegant, antrukket I blå blazer og grå bukser, og vel så spenstig og ungdomlig som sine unge medspillere. Med et velkjent perlerad smil under kort lugg og en noe deformert nese som røper karate-spesialisten. Det var et velvalgt åpningsnummer for et norsk publikum. Det var jo Beatles-melodien Norwegian Wood. La meg fortelle at neste på programmet en blues. Senebu.
Thank you.
Det var Richard Stepton som spilte trombonesoloen. Han utdannet ved Berklee College of Music I Boston. Han har spilt med Woody Herman's orkester og med Maynard Ferguson's storband. Soloen før det var ved baritonsaksofonisten Mauro Turso. Han 32 år gammel fra New York. Han har spilt både swing og bebop jazz og også I diverse rhythm and blues grupper.
Thank you.
Her fikk vi igjen en glimrende demonstrasjon av hva Buddy Rich som storbandleder. Solisten her på tenorsaks var Steven Marcus. Han 38 år gammel og faktisk senior I laget, bortsett fra Rich selv. Da. Han har spilt I Stan Kentons orkester, han har spilt med Buddy Herman og også med Larry Coryell. Og han har også gitt ut 3 egne plater. Trompetsolisten, så vidt jeg kunne se, måtte ha vært Ross Konikoff.
I can't see you out there, but I can hear you, and it's really nice. I'm glad to be here. I hope you're enjoying it. We're going to take a... We're going to take a short intermission of about 15 or 20 minutes, and then we'll come back. Somebody over here wants to hear a big swing face. We'll play that when we come back, and a few other things. See you in about 20 minutes. I thank you for coming out. 20 minutes.
Well, Mr. Rich, you certainly turned us on tonight.
Well, good.
Again.
I'm glad. I'm happy about that.
We didn't expect anything special because all the names on the list, the members of the band, were unfamiliar to us.
Yeah, sure.
Where do you find those guys?
Well, if you look hard enough, I think you'll find the best of almost anything, whether it's music, food, whatever. If you look hard enough, if you have a certain goal in mind, I think you'll succeed.
Mm. How long has this particular band been together?
About 15 months. Mm-hmm. It's really working out very well, too. I think it's the best band I've ever had. As far as soloists, ensemble, I think it's about the best.
All very young guys.
Very young, yes. Average age about 23.
It would be interesting to hear how do you plan a tour like this? How do you go about? Do you have a period of rehearsal and then on tour, or
How is the thing worked out? We work the same way over here as we work in the States. Uh-huh. A tour is lined up for us about a year in advance, and we know just about where we're going. Right now, I know where I'll be up until the middle of next August, so the tours are always planned about a year in advance.
Don't you ever get tired, Mr. Rich?
No, I don't think so. I think it's like anything else. Well, once you become used to a certain way of life and certain hours, it's like anything else. So it's work, but it's also a pleasure and it's fun. Mm. Music is the greatest fun in the world because you're paid a handsome salary and you get a chance to see the world and you get a chance to meet different people throughout the world and you're still doing the thing that you like most. So how can you be tired?
So you won't quit this kind of life, would you?
No, I don't believe so. There's no reason to retire. It isn't a question of finances. I certainly am well enough off. But as long as I can continue to play and enjoy myself, and as long as I can continue to entertain an audience, there's no reason to retire.
What's the situation for big bands in the United States today? Do you have plenty of work to choose between?
Oh, I have all the work I can handle. Like I said before, I'm booked now until next August, and then I'll take a vacation during the summertime at the end of August. And then I continue. We work about 40 weeks out of the year.
Who writes your arrangements?
Oh, let me see. I have about 6 people who write. I have Bill Holman in California who writes, and Phil Wilson who writes for us, and Don Pystrip, and there's a couple of boys in the band who write. So music is continually coming in fresh.
Mm. Would you have any piece of advice to a big band leader who wants to get this thing together?
No, I think not. I think it's presumptuous of people to give advice to other people, because sometimes the advice that you may think is right is wrong for the person that you're giving it to. So rather than do that, I just wish everybody good luck.
Thank you, Mr. Rich.
You're welcome.
Så Buddy Riches råd til andre storbandledere, det ikke annet enn lykke til. Han blir aldri trett, sier han. Musikk, det hans største glede, både økonomisk og det at det gir han sjanse til å se verden og møte andre mennesker. Og han får altså gjort det han helst vil, nemlig å spille. Han betrakter dette bandet som faktisk det beste storbandet han noensinne har hatt. Gjennomsnittsalderen på musikerne her 23 år, sier han. De har holdt sammen I 15 måneder. Og hvordan man finner slike stjernemusikere I den unge generasjonen, ja, det rett og slett bare å lete lenge nok, sier Buddy Rich.